far as I can tell, the only time when I'm not working and you're not working is late at night when we're both sleeping. So the only way to make this thing work is to sleep together.
Ow! Nothing you say is going to convince me to have sex with you.
I say we ought to get married.
Don't you worry about me for one minute.
You're going
to
be fine.
Abe could never bring himself to ask you this, but his mother needs surgery. And I was hoping that you and Mr. Sloan could make us alone.
This is a very difficult time for us right now. If only I had known sooner.
Anybody who is willing to preach to other people had better be willing to listen to a sermon herself now and again. And here is mine. I am not perfect. I never claimed to be. Don't compare me to your husband. And don't blame me for what he did. And if you ever take time off from counting sins, you figure out whether it was better for me to get out of a rotten marriage or for you to stay in one. And then you tell me who's the saint and who's the sap.
I didn't want you to be alone on Christmas.
I know what you're gonna say.
You do?
Yes.
What am I gonna say?
You're too young to get married.
Well, if you know that, why are you going ahead with it?
I know what you're gonna say. It doesn't mean I agree with it.
Well, you are too young.
4 years older than you were when you and Dad got married.
Oh. Do you realize what a serious
undertaking this is? I most certainly do. I haven't slept in days thinking about how serious it is. Ginger and I, we're serious.
And the pre-Cana
classes? Yes. We've already signed up for Father Dreyer's marriage instructions.
Good. I hope neither of you thinks that because you're engaged means that you can engage
No sex before marriage.
You don't have to talk like that.
I'm getting married. I think I can use the word sex.
Oh, you're such a man of the world now.
That was going to be your advice, wasn't it? Maybe not in so many words, but that is what you were going to say.
I was going to remind you that marriage is a sacrament, and that
extramarital intercourse, it's sin.
You're too smart for your own good.
I'm your son.
I guess there's nothing I can say?
You could say, I'm happy for you, Jeff.
I'm worried about you. About your future. I'd always hoped that you would consider college. And Jeff, I'm not going to be able to help you out. I am happy for you.
I knew you could say it.
Got to accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to be affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In-Between. You gotta spread joy up to the maximum. Bring gloom down to the minimum. Have faith or pandemonium. Liable to walk upon the scene. To illustrate my last remark,
Jonah in the whale, Noah in the ark.
What did they do just when everything looked so dark? Man, they said you got to accept.
You ain't the positive, eliminate the negative, and last on to the affirmative.
Don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
For the next 48 hours as rain from the northwest moves.
I don't like hospitals.
We can't very well operate on you at home.
I know that. I'm just expressing my opinion, as I'm entitled to do even in this household.
She's just a bit frightened.
I'm not the least bit frightened, Gloria. I just don't like hospitals.
We're ready.
There are two things I want to say before we leave. Now, the first thing is, I want you to promise to get me my gallbladder.
Why?
I want to make sure that doctor's not just making money off me. I want to see that gallbladder.
I promise I'll get you your gallbladder.
Gloria?
I promise to.
Now, the second thing is, if anything happens to me...
Nothing is going to happen to your mother.
You don't know what the good Lord plans for me, Abel. I might very well die. And I've written it all down here, who gets what here. I don't want you fighting over my things. Now I'm ready.
They say she looked just like her father. Do you think that she looks like you? Well, she has the same dark eyes. But you have dark eyes, too. She's a good baby. She almost slept through all the night. What's it like living with... Are you comfortable here? They've been very kind. Will you watch her while I go get the bottle?
Sure.
Hey, kiddo. Well, maybe you do look like your daddy. But I can't see it. I didn't know when he was your age, though. Only when he was old enough to date. Date and then dump me. Yes, he did. He dumped me. Shh. Sorry. It's all right. It's just the doorbell.
Hello?
Is Mike Sloan here?
Who may I say is calling?
Bill Caswell. He'll remember.
Would you please step inside, Mr. Caswell? I don't want the baby to catch a draft. I'll get Mr. Sloan.
Linda?
Yes.
Linda? Holy smokes, you're as beautiful as he said you were. I'm Bill Caswell.
Hello.
I bet Mike's already told you all about me, but
no,
if he didn't,
no.
I'm the one that saved his hide over in Italy before I got shipped off to the Pacific.
Caswell,
which reminds me,
I swore
that I would bring him one of these, and that's it. Don't tell me, because I already know everything there is to know about you, except I didn't know you guys had a baby.
Don't scare her.
A beaut. Where is that lousy son of a gun? Mike! Oh, sorry, I'll be quiet. What's his name anyway? Little Mikey? Or is it a girl?
The bottle is ready.
A nurse, too? Oh, this kid's living the life of Riley.
I don't know any Bill Caswell.
Well, Gina, Mike didn't tell me he had a sister.
Is no one looking after my granddaughter?
She's getting her bottle just now, Mrs. Sloan.
Boy, heaven save my house. Is this a friend of Linda's? We can't have it.
She is Mike's wife.
But
I am Mike's
she's
wife.
Linda.
She is.
I am.
What gives?
Young man.
Where is that dog face?
He asked for Mr. Sloan.
Oh, my God.
Michael died last September.
Died?
His transport crashed.
Mike died?
I'm sure you mean well, but you have upset my family beyond words. Please leave us in peace. Gloria.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
The CIO today announced a contract agreement with General Motors covering 25,000 members of the United Electrical, Radio, and Machine Workers Union. While another 150,000 remain on strike in other places, locally severe thunderstorms are possible for 48 hours.
Here comes the birthday boy. Happy birthday, Hank.
Thanks.
Oh, you better take your umbrellas. Oh, I wish it would turn to snow.
Well, no thanks. Then I'd have to shovel it. Mom, you said you were considering using your savings to pay off the mortgage early?
Yes.
Your own mortgage is nearly 6%. And with your savings earning 2.5%,
It might be better to refinance now. Mortgage rates are still below 4.5, rather than use up all your savings.
Thanks for keeping me from making a mistake. Now, about your birthday.
Sarah's taking me out.
Oh, just to the roadhouse.
You want to come? Buy a steak, save a dance for you.
Thanks. You kids go and have a good time. I've got things to do. Sure. Mm-hmm.
Okay, but you're welcome if you change your mind.
Thanks. I'll have a little surprise for you when you get back. Don't bother making a cake. I picked up his favorite at the AMP. I hid it in the warming oven. She will be fine.
I know you two don't always see eye to eye.
Abe, I love your mother. I really do.
She can be hard to get along with sometimes.
Honey, if she raised you, she can't be all that bad.
Mr. Davis, your mother is just fine. The operation went like clockwork.
Wonderful.
Oh, thank God.
Thank you.
She's a very strong-willed woman, your mother.
Don't I know? She certainly is.
They'll assign her a room as soon as she gets out of recovery. Expect her to be groggy, and if we're lucky, she'll sleep a good while.
Thank you very much, Doctor. I am very grateful.
Not at all.
Oh, Doctor? The gallbladder?
Yes. It's a good thing we operated.
My mother-in-law had asked to keep it.
Oh, of course. I forgot. Glad you reminded me.
Thank you.
It's beyond me what people do with these things.
What are you doing? Wait one minute. I will not have her in my room.
Lady, please.
I paid good money for this bed, and I am not going to be exposed to the filth and germs that these people carry. Now, get her out of here. Get her out of here.
Please. What's the problem?
You, stay outside. I'm not spending a night with colored. Get that colored man out of my room.
My life. And I'm sure the Lord has even more in store to try my patience. But this is something I will not put up with because an old woman's life is on the line. She wakes up and hears that awful woman screaming at her. Who knows what could happen to her heart? Now, we paid for medical care, and we will get medical care, which includes a decent room for my mother-in-law. So you will shut that loudmouth patient up or move her out? Find my mother-in-law a quiet room, or I will raise so much hell around here, you will wish you had never seen my face.
People are living on top of each other, and they're tired of it.
Is that so?
Mr. Sloan, I read we're already over 1 million families. Families, not individuals, are doubled up with friends and relatives. Why, in Newark, they're planning 300 temporary houses, which is swell, only they need 7,000. In Newark alone. But back east, a high school principal and his family were evicted from the home ec classroom where they had camped out because they couldn't find a home. And a couple million GIs haven't even mustered out yet. They'll all be wanting families, and they'll all be wanting homes.
You're a builder.
I'm an investor who knows where they're going to build those homes.
I wish you luck.
Your son was going in with me.
What?
Your son and I plan to go into business together.
My son was going to take over this company.
Oh, yes, sir, I know. He talked all the time about what you built here. He had great respect for you. I mean to say Mike was going to invest with me.
You came here for a loan.
It's a swell idea, Billy, and if anybody can pull it off, you can. Count me in. You see? Count me in.
You want a loan?
An investment, sir.
How much are you investing?
Every penny I have.
Which is?
My discharge pay, $300.
I wish you luck.
You don't want to invest?
My son never mentioned this real estate business. My son never mentioned you.
You think this is a con?
Yes, I do.
You think I'd come here hat in hand like this if it weren't true?
Yes, I do.
You don't think I have more pride than that? Mr. Sloan, I had to swallow a lot of pride to bring myself to ask a dead body's father for money. I couldn't have done that if I weren't on the up and up. I don't have it in me. You ask my CO if Mike and I didn't talk about this all the time.
That is exactly what a con artist would say.
You calling me a liar to my face?
Mr. Caswell, if indeed that is your name, you are the third so-called army buddy who has tried to tap my bank account since my son's death. It has been an enormous strain just being civil to you. Goodbye.
Hi. I wasn't expecting you.
Does that mean I can't come in?
Don't be silly.
I happen to be in the neighborhood. Oh, I see you're having a party.
Not exactly.
Well, you had a party. Whose birthday?
Hank's.
Oh. Well, I see they enjoyed the cake.
Yeah, I'm the only one who's had any.
Is this a bad time for me to visit?
Why? Just because I made my son his favorite birthday cake and his wife bought this one at the store? And nobody's interested in staying home anyway, because I'm just their old mother who nobody listens to anymore.
Anymore? You mean they used to listen to you?
Not funny.
Someone is crying in her cake.
Cake and ice cream.
Can I warm up your coffee for you?
Yes. Did you know that my youngest son didn't even ask my advice when he decided to get married?
I don't think anybody does that anymore.
Well, maybe that's what's wrong with the world today. And they finish my sentences.
They what?
I start to say something. And my children finish my sentences. Linda... Well, she never took my advice anyway. She's so independent, it scares me. And Jeff especially, they know what I'm going to say before I say it. And it's very... disappointing. They don't want my advice, heavens. My oldest son is giving me advice. Imagine that.
The world is going to hell in a handbasket.
My son was carrying on about interest rates today. And I haven't a clue what he said, because the whole time I was thinking, there's this man standing where my little boy used to be. Where is my little boy? My children don't need me.
I think you need to get out of the house.
It's raining.
It fits your mood. Where are the kids?
At the roadhouse dancing.
Let's join them.
No, we'll just spoil their fun.
Is it a, what's the very bad sin?
Mortal.
Mortal. Is it a mortal sin or a... What's the little one?
Venial.
Venial. Is it a mortal sin or a venial sin to be so full of self-pity?
Yeah. Huh.
Besides, if we do spoil their fun, it'll serve them right for growing up without your permission.
Beer and apple cobbler, my treat. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Thanks, baby brother. Hank, there's a guy at the bar, the GI, says he was a good friend of Mike Sloan's.
Mind if I say hello?
No, come on.
He's tanked.
You and Ginger are actually going to tie the knot.
Yep. So?
No, so. I'm happy if you're happy.
Delirious. Thanks.
Heard you were a friend of Mike Sloan's.
Best damn friend a man could have.
I was a friend of his, too.
Hey, buddy. Any friend of Mike Sloan's is a friend of mine. Bartender! This man wants a beer.
I got one. Thanks.
So have another. Mike's dead, you know.
I know.
Died. Bill Caswell, where's my manners? To whom am I addressing the honor of my pleasure?
Hank, Metcalf. Maybe you want to hold off on that beer, Bill.
That's the last thing I want to do, brother. I see you ruptured duck. Where did you defend the Four Freedoms?
83rd Infantry.
Thunderbolt! I served with Mike till about a year ago. Ended up in the repo depot. Got shipped out to the Pacific. They didn't tell me he was dead. Nobody told me. And he married an Italian. Not that Linda I heard so much about. But I saw his little wop wife. She's a sweetie.
You got a place to stay, Bill.
I'm staying right here.
Hank?
Hey. Meeting ended early?
Charlie runs a fast meeting. I forgot to tell you that Mom baked you a birthday cake.
I know you. Linda.
My Lord.
You know him?
We met.
Know her? I know her like the back of my hand. Mike never stopped talking about you morning, noon, and night. Linda, Linda, Linda. Linda this, Linda that. You are the swellest dame on earth. Will you marry me, Linda?
Bill, what?
No, I'm dead serious, Linda. Mike's not around anymore. Will you marry me?
I hate it when I get all worked up. It stays with me for days.
Well, something had to happen.
I know, but my heart is still pounding when I think how ugly people can be.
Well, it's all over, and you did what was right.
Do you think we should be worried that your mother isn't awake yet?
Doctor said the best thing for her is sleep. She'll be awake soon enough, and you'll be wishing she was asleep.
Oh, go on. You make too much out of that. She's really sweet in her own way.
Sweet is not a word I'd call my mother. But she is my mother.
Mm-hmm.
Sweet is what I'd call my wife.
Mm. I would kiss you for that, but with my luck, she'd wake up for sure and catch us.
Let's try, anyway.
Where's the gallbladder?
Where did you leave it?
I didn't leave it anywhere. Oh, my Lord. Somebody has taken it. Who was in here?
Well, when they moved their woman out, they came in to clean up.
Oh, no. I promised your mother.
She'll understand.
I have never done anything to please that woman. She will not understand. We've got to get another one.
Woman, where are we going to get another gallbladder at this hour?
This is a hospital. They must have plenty.
You're talking nonsense. Sit down in bed and be calm.
It looks just like a chicken liver. I'm going to go get one.
Gloria's running the cats and dogs out there. I will explain to her what happened.
If she wakes up while I'm gone, don't tell her a thing. Gloria.
Davenport.
I don't think this is a good idea.
Oh, I couldn't just leave him there. They'd have put him in jail. Besides, he's a pal of Mike's. And if I'm in the same fix, I want someone to give me a place to stay.
You just make sure you never get in the same fix. I'll get a blanket.
Mom, we're ready for that cake and ice cream.
Who do you think the kids are?
Flying in an opium den. Robbing banks.
Why are you persistent in teasing me?
Because you set yourself up for it. Besides, you overlook silver linings.
There are no silver linings in my children growing up. I hate it. I'm a mother. I was born to be a mother, and my children don't want a mother.
I saw that picture of you in your scrapbook. Dark circles under your eyes. You haven't got dark circles anymore from staying up all night with a sick child.
I liked staying up all night.
Well, you'll get a chance to do it again when you become a grandmother.
And when will that be?
How should I know? And this happens to every parent.
That doesn't make me feel better.
Well, there's nothing you can do about it.
That doesn't make me feel better.
That's because you don't want to feel better, because you Irish aren't content unless you've got something to be melancholy about. You're happy being sad. See, I'm right. You want to feel better? Eat something.
Oh, is that your people's solution to everything? Eat?
My people?
this coming from the woman who polished off half her son's birthday cake?
No. Where do you think your mother is?
Who knows? I wonder who got to her cake first.
Jeff.
It's everything.
Because he's a glutton.
He's a growing athlete.
That's my cake.
I'm missing the party.
Here comes Rip Van Winkle.
So much for a quiet celebration.
Have a seat, brother.
I don't trust those legs.
Oh, they'll be steady enough as soon as somebody hands me a brew.
I'll get you some coffee.
Oh, that's not the kind of brew I had in mind. Linda!
Bill!
You remembered my name. Who are you?
This is my brother Hank and his wife Sarah.
Very pleased to meet you. Mm-hmm. So this is Linda's family. You know, he never stopped talking about Linda as long as I knew him. I know when your birthday is, and this is not your birthday.
It's mine.
I knew it. Yeah. I knew that because Mike was all the time talking about Linda. If you are not the perfect woman on earth, I don't know where she is to hear him tell it. No offense, ma'am. I'm just passing along Mike's opinion. He told me about your first date. Sodas, it's some drugstore, Brandstetter's. You remembered. He told me when he introduced you to his parents that his mother kept pretending to forget your name, and she kept calling you different names. He told me about the time you and him did some smooching down on the 50-yard line one night after a game.
Oh, brother.
And he got his belt buckle caught.
How do you like your coffee, Bill?
Oh, I embarrassed you.
No, you didn't.
No, you don't like talking about Mike. I understand.
I don't mind.
No, I'm way out of line. I should offer my condolences. I'm very sorry.
Mike and I broke up long before. A long time ago. Anybody needs condolences, it's his widow.
Well, what a sweet woman she seemed to be.
Please excuse me. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Well, I guess it's a good thing your sister and Mike went their separate ways before he died.
I guess.
Like her gallbladder.
Well, whatever you say.
I am starting to fall out of love. And my hair. Do you know how long it's going to take me to straighten it again?
I like it just the way it is.
Go on.
The responsibilities of married life are not to be taken lightly. It behooves every couple entering the holy state of matrimony to examine their consciences to make certain the formation of a lifelong unbreakable bond is their firm intent. The engaged couple should not be swayed by concupiscence, nor think of marriage as merely license to partake of carnal pleasure at will. For the primary purpose of the sex act is procreation. While harmony is the ideal of every married couple, perfection in this life is not to be achieved. Therefore, when accord on matters of substance, after prayerful and humble consideration, cannot be reached, it behooves the wife, for the good of the marriage, to submit her will to that of her husband, even as the faithful bend themselves to the will of God. And now, I would like to hear from each of you what you think that means.
Cincinnati.
When?
A couple days. Day after tomorrow.
For how long? Oh. You're leaving for good?
No, well, I might be back sometime.
I guess I'm not surprised you win your election here. On to bigger and better things.
Hope so.
When did you find out?
Just today. That's actually what I dropped by to tell you. But you seem to need cheering up first, so I just got around to it.
The union can assign you like that anywhere?
Well, they tell me where they need me, and I go. Unless there's some special reason for me to stay put.
Give me a reason.
I guess I'm not reason enough, I see.
Just say, please stay. Just say, why don't you stay?
So?
What would happen if I asked him? No, if I'm too forward, I'll frighten him. I've always liked Cincinnati.
Why in hell are we talking about Cincinnati?
You've been there?
A number of times. Kentucky is right across the river. He must think I'm a blithering idiot.
I think I knew that.
If I'm too pushy, I'll scare her off.
They call it the bluegrass state. He's going to laugh at me. He's going to laugh out loud.
Because of,
bluegrass.
Yeah, of course.
Horses eat it.
Kentucky?
Race horses. Are you finished?
Yeah, I'm ready if you're ready.
Anytime you are.
I'll get the check.
Strange that priests give people advice about marriage.
It's their job.
But they don't know anything about it. At least not firsthand.
Because they're not married?
Yes.
I always heard it made them more impartial. Is that the word?
Impartial or ignorant, one.
So you don't think his advice is any good?
I didn't say that.
No, maybe you're right. Maybe you've got a point.
Well, let's get home.
I'm gonna let the rain die down a little bit. It's not safe to drive when it's like this. I'm kind of chilly. How are you?
Fine.
I probably gave us some bad advice, too.
What was that?
Oh, well, when I said the only way I could prove that I wanted to go out with you for the sake of going out with you was to not go all the way.
That was one of the sweetest things you've ever said.
But I'm not so sure it applies anymore.
You're not?
The way I see it, I've already proven everything I need to prove in the area of proof.
I agree.
You do?
Yes, but start the car.
Start the car?
Start the car, take me home.
But you just said...
I agree in principle, but... How can I look Father Dreher in the eye if we go ahead?
Just look at him. He can't tell anything by looking.
Priests can tell by looking, and even if they can't, I'll feel funny, which would show him my face, which is a giveaway, so he'll know, so start the car.
Jim.
Start the car.
Oh.
can't remember when we last had rain like this. Could we hear what the weather report is?
Sure.
A Russian case against the 21 Nazi defendants was opened in Nuremberg by the reading of a 79-page document detailing German wartime atrocities. Locally, the big news is rain, rain, and more rain. Thunderstorm warnings are expected for greater river runs.
Oh, could we leave it on a bit?
For further weather bulletin.
Sure.
That's the news for this hour from WREQ.
This Cincinnati move certainly nips our friendship in the bud, doesn't it? Of course, we could always write. We could be pen pals.
Yeah. I have to weigh the reasons for going against the reasons for staying.
Oh, I didn't mean to suggest that you stay on my account.
I understand.
It would be incredibly presumptuous of me to think that because I enjoy your company that you would change any career plans. As long as you're leaving. Could I have a goodbye kiss?
I'm sorry if I woke you.
No, you didn't. It's a swell thing for you to let me spend the night here.
My brother gets the thanks.
If you had your druthers, I'd be out in the rain.
Maybe on the porch.
Did I try to kiss you?
Proposed marriage, actually.
Did I kill anybody?
Not that I know of.
Did I hit anybody?
I don't think so.
Did I break anything?
No.
Well, 3 out of 4 times I behave myself, that's not a bad percentage.
Would you like some scrambled eggs?
Oh, no, I don't want to put you in any trouble. I'll do it.
You cook?
Well, wouldn't exactly call scrambling eggs cooking, but I learned my way around the kitchen. First, Linda, I've been in the Army so long, I'm out of practice talking to a real live in the flesh American woman. So you'll excuse me if I just point blank ask you, where's the latrine?
It's up the stairs at the end of the hall. It's the only room with the light on.
I'm very grateful. And I hope you'll do me the honor of joining me for a batch of scrambled eggs in a few minutes. Oh, my God. The bartender lives here, too?
What are you doing here?
Emptying my crankcase.
It's all right, Jeff. He's okay. You stayed out late?
You stayed up late? What's that guy doing here? Why didn't anybody save me a piece of cake?
Hank has a soft spot for vets without roofs over their head. We figured you'd had your fair share of cake. I was Father Dreyer's class.
Pretty grim. I didn't have any cake. Linda, why didn't you tell me this was here?
What's here? What? Please.
please report for spring training at our facility in Clearwater, Florida.
Spring training. I got a job.
Just for the record, Linda, what was your answer to my marriage proposal?
I accepted.
I was afraid of that.
It's just practice?
Spring training.
Why do you have to go to Florida?
You can't play ball up here in the winter.
Well, why don't you wait until the weather gets warmer and they come and play here?
That's not the way it works. Ginger, this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. I have to take this.
You want to call off the engagement?
No. I want to get married, and I want you to come with me.
I can't come with you. I can't give up my shot at being a radio star.
Ginger, you answer the telephone.
I do now, but I'll get into the studio before very long.
And how do you know that?
How do you know you're going to make the team?
I don't, but...
I don't either. It's the same thing. Answering the telephones is my spring training for getting into the studio, which is my big leagues.
Well, what are we going to do?
Was anybody awake?
Grandmother Davis.
Mother, you have...
How are you?
How you feel?
Where is it?
Who would have thought such a little thing could cause so much pain?
It looks like a chicken liver.
You think so?
I don't think so. I've been cooking chicken livers longer than you've been on this earth, Gloria. I think I know what a chicken liver looks like. Oh, who would have thought a gallbladder would look like a chicken liver?
You think so? Who would have thought it?
What do you want me to do with it?
Just throw it out.
I thought you wanted it.
I just wanted to know that the doctor did what he said he was going to do.
Mrs. Davis, I'm afraid your roommate will need a little quiet, and visiting hours are over. Mrs. Hosokawa is recovering from...
A Jap?
Mrs. Hosokawa is an American.
A Jap in my room?
Mother, this is a double room.
Double or single, I will not share a room with one of those.
Mrs. Davis, please don't disturb the patient.
After what those people did, I will not spend 1 minute with one of those barbarians.
Mother, this is not one...
They don't even cook their food. How do I know what germ she's bringing in here? Take me home, Abe. I have never spent a minute on the roof with a Jap, and I don't intend to now.
Mother!
I don't know how I'm going to face the kids.
Why do they have to know?
Oh, heavens, I don't mean tell them. They would die. I would die. I meant, I don't know how I'm going to lecture them and keep a straight face. I did what I've always told them not to do. I'll be such a hypocrite.
Yeah, I don't think you should be so hard on yourself. I'd feel like a heel if I made you unhappy.
You're no heel. I know what I did was sinful.
Anne.
I'm not speaking for you, Al. You have your own conscience. I know it was sinful. I went against everything I believe in. I know in my mind with absolute certainty that what happened was wrong. So, why don't I feel terrible about it?
You're asking me?
Waters. Later on Nightline, the high cost of freedom in Russia. A remarkable look at the people of Russia you haven't seen before. Tonight.